everyone. The topic we would like to share today is Bernoullis Principle. Where can we find this phenomenon in our daily life?
Has everyone had this experience where you're waiting for the metro or the high-speed rail, and you're standing near the edge of the platform? You feel like someone is pulling you further out, as if the train itself is sucking you over. This phenomenon has to do with Bernoullis Principle.
Let us now think about two questions. First, take a piece of paper and fold it in half, and blow through the middle like this. What happens to the paper? Does it collapse inwards or does it protrude outwards? The answer is the paper collapsed inwards. Why is this the case? And what does it have to do with Bernoulli's principle? We'll explain in detail later.
Now let's look at another scenario. As before, we take a piece of paper and blow horizontally across the top. What happens to the paper? The result is the paper flies upwards. Isn't this different from what we expected? To understand this phenomenon, we must first understand Bernoulli's principle.
Bernoulli's principle is based on the conservation of energy. Its equation takes this form, where rho means density, v means speed, h means the height of the fluid, g is the gravitational acceleration, and p is pressure. These three terms are the kinetic energy, potential energy, and the pressure, respectively, and the three terms have to add to a constant. So, fluids that are under motion have to obey this relationship. Now, we know what Bernoulli's principle is. We can now explain the two aforementioned scenarios. The first question, blowing air through the middle, causes the airflow to be faster. From the equation, we can see when the speed increases and the constant must remain the same, the sum of the potential energy and pressure must decrease. But because there is basically no change in the height and therefore no change in the potential energy, so the pressure must decrease. If the pressure in the middle decreases, then the unaffected pressure on the outside, the atmospheric pressure, is relatively larger. And so there is a net force inwards and the paper collapses. The second question is similar. Blowing air across the top of the paper causes the airflow on top to be faster and the pressure there to decrease. So now the pressure underneath becomes greater than above, resulting in an upward force that pushes up the paper. So we can see that Bernoulli's principle in simple terms says that speed of the fluid is inversely proportional to the pressure.
In our daily life, there are in fact plenty of examples of Bernoulli's principle. The one that's most widely known is the flight of airplanes. The reasons airplanes can fly are many and complicated, and Bernoulli's principle is one of the reasons. The shape of an airplane's wing is curved at the top and near the front. The airflow is split into the upper and lower by the wing. Because of the shape, the upper airflow speed increases, just like how a stream becomes faster in narrow parts of a river. Because the speed above increases, its pressure is smaller than that below. Therefore, there is an upward force lifting up the airplane. Lastly, there is a most practical application. When you're on your heavy motorbike, speeding passenger you like, is she safe?
I know, this is Bernoulli.
No, this is not Bernoulli's principle. This is an unstoppable force between the two of us. This concludes our presentation today. Thank you for watching.